What was your relationship with Nia like prior to? I mean, obviously on TV, you guys were beating the living hell out of each other, but prior to you guys becoming tag champs, and what is it? How is it now?
I didn't, she was, we were friendly, I guess. She was like another person in the locker room, but our paths never really crossed. I hadn't been up there very long. And then during the time I was, it was like straight into this thing with Becky and then kind of like figuring out where to go from there. So, I don't want to say we were friends, but we weren't like, I didn't have a problem with her.
Sure.
And now obviously we're a tag team, so it's been interesting because that's kind of being thrust again into the deep end, where not only did I not know tag team wrestling, but learning that sort of thing, it would be easier with like a best friend, I would imagine,
Right.
because you know how each other works and you know kind of what each other's thinking and all this, and we didn't have any of that. So it's been, like I said, it's been a fun challenge to kind of learn. And I'm still getting there. You know what I mean? I still feel like we have the titles, but I still feel like we haven't come to full fruition of what we are yet.
Absolutely, absolutely. Now, is there anybody, any teams or footage you have been studying, or been inspired by for this part of your career with the tag teams?
I think that I've tried to watch a lot of. So, like, obviously, not just for the. I think there's some social dynamic that compares us to Kane and Daniel Bryan, but I think more the style, the in-ring
Yeah.
style is. I kind of study in-ring stuff is stuff that I'll sit for hours and I never get tired of. So, just watching a dynamic like that where it's a big guy and like Daniel Bryan and I have a lot of similarities. In the ring, and we have a lot of of common, he trained a little bit with Billy as well, and
Billy
Vincent,
Robinson, you're referring to the father of catches, catch can wrestling.
So I know he's done a little bit of training. Our paths never crossed there, but I know just seeing some of the stuff he does and talking with him. So I think that looking at teams like that where the dynamic is similar to what we have has been really beneficial to me. It's difficult because our dynamic isn't going to be a tag team like, like you think about these legendary pairings that were always only a tag team. We're not
Oh,
like,
yeah. Like, not gonna be Arn and Tully or,
yeah, we're
I
not
know.
doing like this tandem kind of offense and doing these cool double team. That's not what we are.
Right.
So there's a lot of stuff I watch that is like, okay, I can put that over here for later. But like I said, it's been an interesting learning experience.
Like what you hear? Catch full episodes of After the Bell on Spotify. Follow us now and never miss an episode.